Hi, this is Roro. Welcome to Roro Rants. This is very serious. I have something very serious to talk about today. Media has been covering up the racial divide in this country for years. The Civil War has never really ended completely. It's been alive and well in the hearts and deeds of evil men ever since it was declared ended and the slaves were officially freed. After the Civil Rights Act in 1964 and the end of segregation, most white people, especially in the North, went to sleep thinking the fight was over. But any black man, especially those in the South, knew they were still not safe, let alone equal. People are now becoming aware, waking up to this, not because of President Obama or the media, but because of the rise of cell phone cameras and social media showing the murder of thousands of innocent, unarmed citizens at the hands of our police every day, who are murdered. Our police officers who are sworn to protect and serve, and 6 to 10 people every day are murdered by the police. This is more people than are killed in the wars in the Middle East. Statistically, a young black man is safer going into the army than living in the United States. That is sad. Largest cause of death of young black males is being killed by police officers. And these are only the ones that are getting reported. I have a website, you can look at the link below, killed by police. And these are only the ones that we know about. I'm sure they're hiding a lot more. The worst part about it is almost all of them are innocent, unarmed, and totally unnecessary. They're situations that are escalated by police, like a traffic violation being escalated into a murder. Even if they are guilty of some small crime, they should not be killed. Running away from a police officer is not justification for murder. They have their right to due process. Police are not supposed to shoot to kill unless their life is in danger. And on many of these videos, you can see clearly their life is not in danger. This was ruled in the Supreme Court, Tennessee versus Gardner, many, many years ago. The bigger problem with this, other than that it's happening, is that the police officers are not being held accountable. And if they're not being held accountable, it's going to keep happening. Our criminal justice system is broken. It's not a criminal justice system, it's an injustice system. The private prison system has to end. It's modern day slavery. The school to prison pipeline is real. The system is targeted at minorities. Hillary had awesome plans to reform our criminal justice system. Instead, we now have a president who is saying his plan is stop and frisk, which has been ruled unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. Stop and frisk, law and order. We know stop and frisk is targeted at minorities. It's been, the Supreme Court said it's because of racial profiling, they made it unconstitutional. In addition to police killing people of color, we have terrorist attacks at churches being burned, the 9 black people that were killed in the church in South Carolina last summer, and countless other hate crimes. We don't even have good statistics because so many people, so many of them are not reported for fear of retaliation. But no one's talking about the cause of so many murders and why they're going unpunished. Nobody's admitting to the real issue of why we as Americans tolerate racism in our country. The United States of America, where we're all supposed to be created equal under the law, regardless of race, color, religion, sex, national origin, the melting pot of the world, where we're supposed to value diversity and celebrate our different cultures and traditions. You know, on Veterans Day, I thought about, you know, our veterans who died for all of our rights, and they're just being trashed on. Our rights are just being trashed. Well, I'm going to talk about it today. I'm going to talk about what the cause is. There are terrorist organizations of white supremacists in this country. The KKK, the Nazis, the skinheads, the Aryan brothers, the countless others. The Southern Poverty Law Center documented 892 active hate groups in the United States in 2015. They're responsible for killing hundreds of thousands of U.S. citizens in this country. They're a much bigger threat than ISIS, yet they are not even recognized as terrorists. Our government spends trillions of dollars on fighting a war on radical Islamic terrorism against a group of terrorists that has only killed about 3,000 American civilians total since 1995, including the ones that were killed on 9/11. 3,000 people total since 1995. But these white supremacist hate groups, they commit 200,000 to 300,000 hate crimes a year, and they kill thousands, probably about 2,000 to 3,000 civilians a year, more than in the Islamic ones have killed in 20 years, every year. And our government does not investigate these hate groups and doesn't investigate them at all, doesn't even identify the problem. This travesty of justice in our nation is responsible for about 3,000 deaths a year, pain and suffering of monumental proportion for the families of these victims. Why is this injustice ignored by our so-called Justice Department? You want to know why? Because these white supremacists hold powerful positions in the government. They are the government. Let that sink in. Think about this. If you're not black and you don't know how this feels, how would you feel if you lived in Iran and you were a Christian or a Jew? You'd be living your whole life knowing that under the law you're supposed to be protected, but you never know when someone might go full jihad on your ass because they will probably not be punished and they know it. I actually worked with a guy who was Jewish and from Iran. The poor guy was traumatized. Thank God he made it here. But this is what a lot of our citizens live with every day. They may not know it. Some of them may not even know it until it happens to them. So how do these white supremacists get away with this? How do we not rise up against them and do something about this? Why can't we enact laws or do something? How do they get away with inciting violence against a whole groups of U.S. citizens when we have so many laws on the books? They use the argument that they have freedom of speech. Hate and racism is allowed in this country because it's considered some derangement of our First Amendment rights. Now, since the end of World War II, most European countries enacted hate speech laws because of the Holocaust, because of the genocide that they witnessed. But hear this truth. Allowing hate speech is a way of inciting violence. Children learn it from their parents. But even worse, by allowing this terrorist group to operate freely in high positions, high offices of our government, the United States of America is actually condoning genocide. 2,000 to 3,000 people killed every year, and no investigation into these hate groups? No punishment? and this is under a Democratic black president, what's going to happen now with our president-elect who's been endorsed by the KKK? Yeah, they threw a parade for him. That happened. I know many of you are thinking, I'm trying to start a race war by making this video, I'm trying to stir the pot. No, I'm just giving you the numbers, the facts. Look them up yourself. I put all the links down there, and you decide what you want to do with those facts. That's up to you. You can keep your head buried in the sand. That's your choice. Or you can wake up to the fact that you live in a country where our government condemns genocide in other countries, yet ignores it here in our own. And you can get out there and join those protesters. Start a protest in your own city if there isn't one. Or go to cities where there, take some big groups of people and go to cities where there are no protests. This is Roro Rants. I'm gonna leave you with this message. Thanks.
Picture this. A group of politicians from the 13 American colonies come together in this building, right here, to plot what turns out to be a revolution.
We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That to secure these rights, governments are instituted among men, deriving their just powers from the consent of the governed. That whenever any form of government becomes destructive of these ends, it is the right of the people to alter or to abolish it, and to institute new government, laying its foundation on such principles, and organizing its powers in such form as to them shall seem most likely to affect their safety and happiness. But when a long train of abuses and usurpations, pursuing invariably the same object, evinces a design to reduce them under absolute despotism, it is their right, it is their duty, to throw off such government and to provide new gods for their future security.